gratitude to the Divine Mother that we all are present here. So as Didi was saying, that we always aspire for the happiness, but at the end we have to compromise with the pain. Pain and pleasure, these two are the eternal partner. They don't, like, they always quarrel with each other, but they always enjoy with each other because they are married. They don't get divorced. So when we were asking a question that why a little boy who doesn't even earn anything, he is so much happy and content in his life. What is the secret behind that? And even when you look at that particular child, that happiness will also ignite within you. You will also become happy when you see a little child. But when you see a elder child, that means the young or the grown-up person, you will not feel the same kind of vibration. The vibration that particular child was releasing. We believe it or we don't believe it, there is always a greater power whom we call as God, is guiding our life. He is always there to help us. If He is there to help us, who is omnipotent, who is almighty, then He could have, like, done a better thing for us. He could have wiped out all the suffering, all the pains from our life. But still, why do we have to, like, face that? Actually, the reason lies within ourselves. What happened, once there was a plane, actually it was traveling, lot of passengers were in that plane, and suddenly it started vibrating. And there was an announcement in that plane that please put your belt, hold tightly your seat, there is a danger. So all of the passengers who were traveling in that plane, they suddenly became panic. They became restless. Like, what will happen? Whether we will be alive or we will be we are traveling in the journey of the death. We don't know what is going to happen next moment. But in that plane, there was a little girl who was calmly sitting in his seat. So there was a lady just sitting next to that little girl. She questioned her, like, how can you be so calm in this panic situation? Like, we don't know what is going to happen, whether we will be alive or we are going to die. But with this situation also, like, all of the passengers, they are praying God that please save us. Means we have done so much of cruelty in our life, but this is the last time in our life that we want to surrender everything. We will not do any kind of wrong things if we will be alive. This is how we want to communicate, right? Like we used to communicate with God. But how can you be so calm? Then she said, you know, who is the pilot of this plane? He is my father. And if my father is driving the plane, then why should I be worried? So the definition of suffering is the lack of faith we have in that Almighty. The situation are same, even for that little kid, even for the grown up. But that faith of that little kid, that if anything will happen, my parents are with me. They bother much more about me than myself. And that faith makes him relax. That faith helps him to remain quiet in his life, the calmness in his life. And as we grow up, we lose that faith. Actually, our faith is our strength. the faith on that Almighty, that He can do anything. But we have to have a faith on Him. Then only we can make the flow of that force. If some guest will visit to your home and he will knock your door, but until unless you open the door, can he come inside? He won't. Right? So that is why you might be wondering that why all of a sudden we have been told about God and divinity. This is the topic that we should preach our grandfather or grandmother, because they do have a lot of time. We are so busy in our life, even we are busy than the Prime Minister of India. We have to come to school, then go to tuition, then we have to do a lot of homework. But we could get time for playing video games, but we don't have time or to watch our favorite series. But we don't have time to pray the Divine or God. And when the God will be remembered, like when we remember God, just before the exam. Right? God, like tomorrow is my exam. Last time I prayed to a lot, but unfortunately in mathematics, I got simply escaped. But this time I pray you sincerely, please help me to get good marks. This is how like we need God, only for marks. Only for our success, only for the like for our eldest one, only for the money. That we think that God is somewhere sitting above, and whatever we wish, He is bound to do that. If He is not able to do that, then what power He has? He is not the God. But why really we need divine in our life? So, in this school, like when we entered, there was a lot of security check. There are not like two gates are there, one gate, they didn't allow, then we have to take another route and we have to come here. So, you can see a lot of soldiers here. Do you know the definition of soldier? Whom you call as a soldier? One who protects us. Whom we call as soldier? You look like, your haircut looks like soldier's haircut. Please stand up. Whom we call as soldier? One who fight for us. Great. This is the one. You are fit for a soldier. So usually how we define a soldier? By his uniform. If he carries a gun.
For his
bravery. Even if he is qualified in the exam. Even if he has all the like marks, he has all the strength to become a soldier, until unless he has the courage to fight, he is not a real soldier. Otherwise, whenever the war will be announced, he will be sitting in his home thinking, what will happen to my life? So that courage, do you have in your syllabus? Do you have in your syllabus in Kendra Vidyalaya? Is someone teaching you how to be courageous? Is it there in your mathematics, science, chemistry, in the subject? Where does it come from?
Ourselves.
And how we can learn that? You know, how to develop the courage? Is it coming from outside or it is within you? It is within ourselves, because whenever something happens to our best friend, all of a sudden the courage will come and we will fight for it. We will not think about ourselves. So that courage comes from a divine quality. So that is why we need the divine. Because whenever we have a problem, what we used to pray to God, come like a superman and take take us away from this problem. But you know what mother says? I am not a mother. If you are sinking in the water, I will just put a rope and get you away from that water. I am the mother. If you are sinking in the water, I will also sink with you. So you might be wondering, I am also sinking and why? You will sink. Right? So again she is saying that you need to sink because you need the experience of sinking. If you want to learn swimming, if you stand just above the water, can you learn swimming? You have to get down or get into the water. There many times you have to sink, and by sinking only, because that is not the failure, that is the part of the learning. So all the failures that we face in our life, unless we declare it as a failure, it is not failure. It is the part of the learning that we are getting. So you need to sink because you need the experience of sinking. And why I will sink? Because in spite of everything, nothing will happen to you because divine is with you. So that's why I will sink. So when we face any difficulties in our life, what should be our prayer? Ki, oh God, give me your strength so that I can face this difficulty. I don't want to escape out of this difficulty, because each difficulty carries a secret knowledge, a secret learning of our life. If you face that difficulty, you will be awarded with that learning. So that is how we should aspire God, and that is how we should pray God. It is like we just want to, the way we deal with our other persons, we think God is also like that. We can cheat him. We can give him some coconut and he will fulfill us our wishes. But he has a greater power to give us. He has the divine power that we can culture in ourselves. Like we can pray that God, please make us courageous. Divine, please make us truthful. That kind of prayer we can make. But how we pray? You know, like one day there was a painting competition in the classroom. And the theme was superhero. Let's say in your classroom also, there is a painting competition and the theme is superhero. So who will be the superhero for you? Can anyone tell, like your superhero? You please. Superhero. Please.
Dad.
Your dad. Why?
Because he
does
everything for me.
Okay, thank you. Nice answer. Next? Any different answer?
Your mom, my grandmother. My grandfather.
Your grandfather.
Because he inspires me.
He inspires me. Any other answer? No celebrity? Shahrukh Khan, Salman Khan, Spider-Man, Iron Man? No different answer? Soldier? I thought like you will draw some of your like teachers who are like sitting here. No list out of that? Any different answer? You know, everyone in the class, they drew this Iron Man, Spider-Man, their parents, okay, and some great persons. But there was one particular picture. There was a picture of a small kid who was holding a broomstick in his hand, and there was a a cloth was also there. He was standing like this, like a sweeper. So all of a sudden the teacher thought, like, why the sweeper will be the superhero? He was not able to understand the reason. Then he inquired, what is the reason behind that superhero? And he was like searching for that particular boy who drew that pen. But he was not present there. He already left the school, like, for that day. Then when the teacher asked his friend told the entire school that every day that boy used to leave early from the class. And why he used to leave there? Because that boy doesn't have his father, like, he already passed away, his father already passed away. He has only his mother. And his mother, she is a sweeper. She used to clean the road. And this boy, he used to leave the class early because he wants to help his mother. He used to go there and he will put up all the dresses, like long clothes and then that broomstick, and he will dress up like a sweeper, and then he used to clean that road. And while cleaning that road, he used to think himself as the superhero. And that's why that particular boy drew that road. So, if you think here, when you think about yourself, what kind of aim you have in your life? You used to think about doctor, engineer, teacher. But if you don't culture the good quality in yourself, even if you become a doctor and you are doing cheating in your examination, what kind of doctor you will be? A corrupted doctor. So instead of helping the patient, we will force the patient to collect all the money, otherwise he will be dead. So that's why what mother said, that why do we come to the school? Like, why do we study? Mother said, it is not for our family. It is not for our family that we are studying here. It is not to secure a good position. In society, we have to be IAS, a doctor, because that is how, like, we prefer our aim. It is not to earn money. We are not studying here to earn money. It is not to obtain a diploma, to get a good certificate, to get a good position in the class. We are not coming to school. So can you please raise your hand if you don't come to school for any of this reason? You are not coming to school for your family. You are not coming to school to get a good position in the society, not to earn money, not to earn good certificate or diploma. What is the purpose of coming to school? What is the purpose of studying here? Then mother said, we study to learn, to know, to understand the world, and for the sake of the joy that it gives us. We study for the joy of studying, because we are learning the good thing. So no work is small or like great, because that sweeping work, if you ask your parents that I want to become a sweeper, then there will be lot of disinterest, right? How can you be the sweeper? What will be your status? But you think of that particular boy, what kind kind of joy he was getting while he was doing that work, while he was helping his mother. That joy you cannot compare with anything. So we are learning here because of that joy of learning. Because if we learn for the joy of learning, then we can aim for the perfection. So our aim is not success. Our aim is not money, power or success or to get a good status in the society. Our aim should be to do any work, whatever work we are doing, if we can do it perfectly, if we can do it as an instrument of the divine, because he is the source of perfection. If we can become his instrument, then in that perfection, we can get the joy. We can get that pleasure if we can get united with him.